Welcome back.
Sorry. What's our situation?
Let's just say Shiva and Titan's little spat hasn't made things any easier. And?
It's as you thought. The Crusaders have sounded the retreat.
Then we follow.
We're down a man, Sergeant.
If we return without Shiva's head, our fate will be no different from Beast's. I'll take my chances with the Iron Blood. At least then I might die fighting.
After you do, that is.
I won't be dying. Not today.
Then it's settled. No dying. Now, if you don't mind, we have an army to chase.
How do they expect us to kill something that can do this?
They don't.
only the... holding its leash. Trails are gone. It'll be hell finding a way out.
Do you think a retreating army and their dominant will fare any better?
The flames.
Titan has knocked the fight out of our Ironblood friends. Where are the rest of them? That can't be the main host.
Wait.
Ingvat! Petra!
Our fortunes have turned, Sergeant. It's her.
The Dominant? Are you certain?
The Crystalline Orthodox is a backwards faith for a backwards people. In the Iron Kingdom, they teach that Dominants are unclean aberrations. Born of blackest sin. Only their priests are allowed to perform the rites of priming. And I see many.
We end this quickly.
Shrinkskart! Adioninir Sagarid! Strach!
Please.
What alvation now, King Alad Scully asked.
Is she dead?
I don't think so.
Well, what are you waiting for? I'll bloody do it then.
Fuck. We've got company, Wyvern. What are you doing?
Lord Ohida Vedra!
Get your ass over here and help me with these bastards!
I'm sorry, Jill.
With you, Wyvern?
Dominant. I know her.
Know her? Look around you. Do you think any of these animals care? I need you here!
That's done.
I won't ask you again, Wyvern. Take her head so we can be done with this.
I can't. I won't.
You would betray the Holy Empire?
Betray? I don't recall ever pledging allegiance to your Emperor. My service may have been bought with this brand. But not my loyalty. I just fight to survive.
And you think I don't? The Empire will have our heads if we return empty-handed. So if you won't take hers, I'll have to take yours.
I told you, Sergeant. I'm not dying here today. And neither is she. Let's find out.
Wyvern! Have you forgotten who plucked you from the front lines? Who trained you? Who gave you a name when you had none?
You speak as if we don't bear the same brand, Sergeant.
I've always had a name, and I've not forgotten it.
Still clinging to the past like a torn blanket.
Then you will die, as you should have 13 years ago.
For nothing! No one! And I will not fall by your hand! My man! By a traitor's blade!
This way.
Sid!
Bloody wind. Well, come on then.
Hugo, dear, my proud desert lion. Would that you had taken care when chasing the hare. I expected more from the mighty Titan. You put the Ice Queen on her back, no doubt. But you'll have to work harder if you're to claim this prize.
My lady, the thunder.
We'll be hearing more soon enough. We're fucking snakes, Sid. Gather the men. We have work to do.
Jill. Is it really you? And who's this fine hound I see before me?
A fine hound who saved your life, that's who.
Torgal.
Aye?
His name is Torgal.
You two acquainted? Well then, you won't mind taking him off my hands. Funny. I'd always pictured you as more the chocobo type. Clive Rosfield. Come now. Fleet as flame, fierce as a wildfire. That there was the blessing of the Phoenix. I'd heard rumors that you'd survived, but I never paid them much heed. Calm down. I didn't come all this way for your handsome mug. Now her, on the other hand, she seemed worth muddying my boots for. none the worse for wear. Still, might be best to get a second opinion. Back her up.
Not another step. I mean it.
Well, I'm not about to leave her here. Not one with a warm bed waiting. It's all right. You're welcome to join us. You do want to help her, don't you?
Sid, if we aren't back soon, Nan will have our heads.
I'll explain everything once we're back at the hideaway. Come on. Not much further now.
But we're in the middle of the Deadlands.
Keen eye, you. The blight sucked this place dry. Meaning no trees, no birds, and no magic. But it also means no neighbors.
The last place anyone would think to look.
Home sweet home.
This place. These are fallen ruins.
Well, we didn't think they'd mind. And it keeps the black from our lungs.
But how do you survive without magic?
How does anyone? Hard work and a bit of nous. You must be starving. We grow them here, believe it or not. Suit yourself.
You're back.
Ah.
are you?
And this is the Dominant.
How cold since we found her. I was hoping you might give her a look over.
All right. Goots, get her upstairs.
Well, none will...
Don't fret about Karen. I've taken care of her fee.
All of it.
She's the best healer this side of the belt. You've nothing to worry about. Go on. Have a look around. I'll be in my solar.
There's a good girl. Hungry, are you? Cid says we shouldn't travel alone, but the Deadlands here are unforgiving. Still, needs must.
You reckon he's a soldier, then?
Be surprised if he wasn't. The smell of war is thick about him.
Still hungry, are you? Might have something round here.
Another newcomer. You mind the rules round here, or our next chat will be through the bars.
The washroom floor's all mended then?
It'll hold. For now.
Now I suppose I'll be needing a new sword.
Then you'll need to speak with Blackthorn.
Hmm.
Sid once told me, the Blight doesn't kill the land, it only makes her forget who she once was. She'll eventually remember her purpose. All she needs is a little reminding. Sid once told me, the Blight doesn't kill the land, it only makes her forget who she once was. She'll eventually remember her purpose. All she needs is a little reminding.
Your brand. Lady Tyre might be able to see to that. You may have been born a slave, but you're a free man now. Your brand. Lady Tyre might be able to see to that. You may have been born a slave, but you're a free man now. Leave me be.
Not until you've had your medicine.
These apples are all foul.
Would you rather you went without?
Too. If you can read, don't let Otto know. We'll put you to work on the ledgers too.
Most concerning.
Struck his yoke, did break his life, his own again. With thunder's roll, he knew his fate and would fight it to the end. Well, what do you think? I woke this morn inspired. When lightning struck his yoke.
I've spent the whole morning on these steps.
Working on a pet project of mine. Though she's not above biting the hand that feeds her. All right. I was hoping we might try and solve the mystery of poor Clive Rossfield. A bearer of the Sambrequois Imperial Army sent behind enemy lines. With orders to wait until it turned into a brawl, then slit the Dominant's throat in the chaos.
I didn't know it was her. How could it be?
And so, to save her neck, you slit your sergeants, then set your sights on the hills, conveniently forgetting how the Empire deals with deserters. Because with that on your chop, my friend, we both know you won't be getting far.
You've fallen a long way, Lord Rossfield. I'll not have it said that I'm a poor host.
What do you mean to do with her?
Do with her? Why, nothing. Her life is her own now. If I wanted to use her, do you think I'd be talking to you? All I want to do is help. Dominance like her, branded like you. Of course, the realm doesn't approve, which is why we live in a cave. And it's also why we need help. From branded who know one end of a sword from the other. What say you, Clive? Will you join us?
Sid, was it? I trust that you'll do right by Jill. But until my brother is avenged, I must walk my own path.
Avenged.
My brother was murdered by a second dominant of fire.
The Phoenix is evil twin. Well, bugger me. Another rumor proven true.
I only stand here today because of Joshua. 13 years I've waited for this chance. I've slept in filth, drunk from a gutter, killed more men than I can count. You're right. The Empire will not suffer a deserter. This will be my best opportunity. My last.
Which is why you should join us.
I told you I'm not...
interested, I know. One of my scouts sent word there's a group of branded fugitives north of here, in the Imperial village of Lost Wing. Among them is one he believes to be a dominant of fire.
Is he certain?
What say we go and ask him?
This doesn't mean I'm joining you.
Best make ready, then. You'll find everything you need down in the main hall, as well as a few things you don't. Have fun. It's downstairs. Try not to get lost.
On these steps.
When lightning struck his
if you can read, don't let Otto know.
Goot, was it? Perhaps you can help. Sid asked me to make ready for our mission. How does one go about that here?
There's old Nan's place. On second... you maybe want to see Blackthorn first.
A blacksmith? To the forge it is, then.
Oh, wait, no, hold up. You'll be needing this. Blackthorn won't take no notice of you otherwise. Might not anyway.
Fancy a mug of Kenneth Coldus when we're done.
This Titan ship bold is.
Does it look like this room here for another bloody crate?
Are you Blackthorn?
What if I am? I've no time for idle chatter.
I'm not here to talk. I'll be accompanying Sid to Lostwing and I need you to see to my equipment.
You could be accompanying the goddess Grieger to our holy bedchamber, Frawler. I care.
I'm not lifting a finger for you.
Is that so? Do you want that or not? I can take it back.
Oh. Damn you, Goots.
All right. No need to be hasty. Let's have a look at you. I doubt that lot could stay a Moogle's fart. Bloody Imperials. They'd rather see their bearers dead than kitted out properly. I'll do what I can, as a favor to Goot's mind. And the belt, Caesar Square. You want anything else, you bring your own materials.
I'll bear that in mind. Thank you.
A word of advice. Don't let Sid decide what's best for you.
I suppose I should thank Goots.
Anything needs repairing. So, what'll it be? Bad, if I do say so myself. And?
Fancy a mug of Kenneth Cole's.
You take it back and tell that blockhead I'm not paying for stuff I didn't ask.
The gift worked. You have my thanks.
Come on, nearly there. Blankets, quick as you like. All right, we make him comfortable while the bed's made up. Well, you're just gonna stand there. Someone fetch some water.
I'll get the bucket. You go and see if Otto needs out, eh? Yeah.
Wait, me? What the hell have I got myself into?
Most of the world would leave hard work like this to bearers.
Seeing as you're new, let me share a word of warning. Keep your hands out of the stores, or I'll cut them off and crate them with the others.
I'm only teasing. We feed the hands to the dogs.
Another newcomer. You mind the rules round here?
What are you gawping at, newcomer? What
What are you gawping at, newcomer? Never seen a man work with his hands? Well, you best get used to it if you're thinking of staying.
I heard they escaped their masters in the Imperial capital. By the look of those bruises, not a moment too soon.
Yeah, well, it doesn't matter where they came from. Only that they're here now.
You another one of Sid's strays?
What?
We all are. Littlins, biggins, and everything in between. We're a damn sight better off here than out there in the world.
Sid once told me the Blight doesn't kill the land, it only makes her forget who she once was. She'll eventually remember her purpose. All she needs is a little reminding.
Your brand. Lady Tyre might be able to see to that. You may have been born a slave, but you're a free man. Leave me be.
She's not going to heal any quicker with you hovering around like a blood fly. She's not going to heal any quicker with you hovering around.
Sounds like trouble's brewing in the main hall. No rest for the wicked, eh? Sounds like trouble's brewing in the main hall.
Careful, you. I've spent the whole morning on this.
When lightning struck his yoke.
Do you think we should go and help?
It sounds like the floor has everything under control. As always.
Read. Don't let Otto know.
What's all the commotion?
Looks like we've got some new customers.
Are we safe?
Who are they?
Huh? They're freed Imperial bearers. Who the hell are you? Shit, at this rate, he won't make it through the night. Think you can find your way up them stairs to the infirmary? We need Tyre. Well, go on. Shift your ass.
Was Tyre the one looking after Jill?
Top of the stairs, first door on your right. Quick.
Does this look like an infirmary to you?
Your friend needs her rest. There'll be time for tearful reunions once she's recovered.
I'm not here for Jill. You're wanted downstairs. There are injured bearers in need of attention.
Well, why didn't you say so?
I did say so.
He's going to be all right. but I'll need to examine them both in the infirmary. My work's just begun.
Another fine day at the hideaway.
Do many of the bearers who come here arrive in this state?
It's no easy thing, casting off your chains. By the time most pluck up the courage, they're already far gone. These two here are the lucky ones. The name's Otto. You need anything? You ask me.
Well, Otto, I do need some supplies.
Do you now? Then Lady Karen over there will be more than happy to help you.
Right.
Oh. And thanks. Be seeing you.
Not likely. I won't be staying.
Is that right? Well, for as long as you are here, consider yourself welcome. You helped us today. And we won't forget it. Thank you.
these people.
Don't think I haven't noticed you stealing sips from that pot. Ah, a new face, and, dare I hope, a willing pair of hands. The fat chocobo is a demanding mistress, and we are too few to keep her on her feet. Might I persuade you to deliver a meal or two to souls in need of sustenance? For your trouble, I can offer you the contents of my strongbox and my enduring gratitude.
I don't see why not.
Marvelous. And who exactly do I have the honor of addressing?
Clive.
Delighted to make your acquaintance, Clive. I'm Kenneth, and mine are the weary shoulders upon which the weight of this fine establishment rests. Now, I have three hungry customers awaiting their victuals. Take these if you would, and be careful. They're hot.
Were quick to sound the retreat once Titan turned up.
Fat lot of good that icon of theirs did.
You'd think he'd have time for a nip with old August before scampering back to his solar, but no.
Lonely, are we, August?
He's not out chasing rumors. Sid's up there in that hole. Of his brooding and scheming.
Lay off the man. He's got plenty to brood about.
The Iron Blood were quick to sound the retreat once Titan turned up.
Fallon.
Yeah. Oh, my thanks. I hope you do not think me lazy for waiting to be served like a lord. Only my former master did not use me kindly, you see. He left me half lame, truth be told. But Sid took me in nonetheless. Well, the hideaway is the home I never knew, and a mighty fine one at that. I'd been cast out and left for dead when Sid found me. There's not a day goes by.
Your food.
I was hoping it might be. Well, doesn't this look fine? Thank you, lad. You're new, aren't you? Kenneth's running you ragged already, I expect, the old rascal.
Well, he did say he'd give me something for my trouble.
And so he should. We're not slaves anymore. Well met, lad. And keep up the good work. It's nice to see the hideaway finally coming alive. Wasn't so long ago us old hands were rattling up on the turned up.
I'd be cast out and left for dead when Sid found me.
Next time you're in, first round's on the ass.
If you can read, don't let what I know. We'll put you to work on the register.
Well, well. There's so much more to farming than just seeds and soil.
Your food.
Just a moment. I need to finish this. I won't be a burden. I'm of no use to anyone as I am, but maybe if I can master this.
All right, but see that you eat it before it gets cold.
Of course. Thank you.
That's the last one. I'd better let Kenneth know.
Next time you're in, first round's on the ass.
If you can read, don't let Otto know. We'll put you to work on the ledgers too.
All done, I presume?
Splendid.
They were bearers. All three of them. Not slaves waiting upon their master's pleasure, but... Men waiting to be fed like equals.
Indeed. Equality is the very cornerstone upon which our little community is founded. Beyond these walls, we are scorned as slaves. Speaking only when spoken to, eating only what scraps our masters deign to give us. The first hot meal here is the first many will have known. In the hideaway, we are free. Truly free to speak as we please, when we please, and to eat what and when we desire. More than reason enough to trust in Cid's vision, wouldn't you say? Now, I promised you something for your trouble, did I not? The contents of my strongbox are yours to do with as you will. Thank you, Clive. Do come and visit me again, won't you?
you think we should go and help?
Yours is not a familiar face. Are you new to the hideaway, perchance?
You could say that.
Well then, allow me to welcome you. I am Harpocrates II Hyperboreus.
That's quite
a mouthful, I know. Which is why everyone here has taken to calling me simply Tomes. On account of the company I keep. And what varied company. I'm a collector, you see. Not of bijou and baubles, but of stories. The history and culture of these isles have ever been a source of endless fascination to me. But alas, my days of wandering the realm in search of new tales are far behind me. And so I've taken to sharing that which I've gathered with all who might listen. Perhaps you would care to listen. When I was very young, yet, when I arrived, fortunately, I don't believe you've read this particular chapter before. I have compiled some new entries, if you would like to see them. You wish to study the tomes? you learn everything you needed?
I heard they escaped their masters in the...